The NASCAR Pinty Series returns to the Maritimes, and Canada's top stock car racers meet for the annual East Coast Showdown. From the foothills of the Rockies, across the prairies, through Ontario and Quebec, racers now return to one of the most challenging and fastest ovals in the land. We're in Antigonish, Nova Scotia, for the Bumper to Bumper 300 from Riverside International Speedway.
And welcome to the ninth race of the 2016 Pinty Series calendar. I'm Dave Bradley. Along with me is the voice of the NASCAR Series in Canada, Mr. Adam Ross, and veteran reporter Todd Lewis is trackside. Adam, this third of a mile Riverside track is one to be reckoned with.
Dave, this is one of, if not the best racing tracks in all of Canada. Opened in 1969 by local businessman John Chisholm, the track was revamped in 2006 as a third-mile version of the Bristol Motor Speedway. This place begs for side-by-side racing.
And, of course, Mr. Chisholm passed away in 2014. He was inducted into the Canadian Motorsport Hall of Fame a year later. His son Donald accepted on behalf of the family.
And, of course, Donald is back racing with us tonight. He'll be behind the wheel of the number 89 Nova Construction Ford. He won this race 2 years ago.
And Donald isn't the only Maritimer in the lineup. We have 15-year-old Waylon Farrell from Conception Bay, South Newfoundland. He's behind the wheel of the number 46 Farrell Excavating Dodge.
And, Dave, the series is still a two-horse race in the points championship. Veteran Andrew Ranger has a five-point lead over 16-year-old sensation Caden Lapcevich.
Earlier, the field lined up for E3 Spark Plug time trials, and with more in our front row, here's Todd.
Thanks, guys. A nice story tonight for our E3 Spark Plugs poll winner. It's the 89 of Donald Chisholm, of course, long associated with Riverside International Speedway. Circled this one-third mile oval in a time of 14.6 seconds, a speed of 82 miles per hour. Second career pole. First time he was on pole, he was a winner in 2014. Alongside on the front row, it's the 32 of Alex LeBay. Long faces on this team after practice. They were concerned about speed, weren't sure the car was quick enough. Few adjustments after practice. Second quick in qualifying, he starts alongside on the front row looking for his second career victory tonight. Let's go up the track to get the proceedings started.
Riders, start your engines!
And that's the way to get the crowd fired up here at Riverside International Speedway. You see engines fire up here on the front straightaway. You see the crews tending to the window nets, making sure they're secure.
And one great story in this field, Dave, the Admiral brothers from Edmonton, Alberta. From what I gather, 11 of them rode together across the country, a 56-hour drive.
That is a road trip if I've ever heard one, swapping seats along the way, I'm sure.
We'll be on board tonight with Ian Admiral in the 83 machine, as well as Mark Dilley in the Leadland 02.
The field rolls off. Let's take a look at the WeatherTech starting lineup. And you'll see the front row is Donald Chisholm, now LeBay, as Todd mentioned earlier. Row number two, Jason Hathaway in the three, LP Dumoulin in the 47.
Back to the third row brings us DJ Kennington and Alex Tagliani alongside. Row number four, Mark Dilley and Kevin Lacroix, last race winner.
Looking back to row number five, and that'll bring us the smiling face of Caden Lapcevich, and there's Kelly Admiral in the 56. Row six has Waylon Farrell in the 46 and the 59 of Gary Klute.
In row number seven, Dwayne Baker makes his return to the series with Andrew Ranger. Not as good a qualifying run as we would expect. Adam Martin makes up row number eight alongside with Ian Admiral.
And you see the cars all able to move here as they start circulating to get some heat in the tires. A great crowd on hand here at Riverside International Speedway. This race generally brings out the fans.
And they're giving them a send-off in style. And that overhead view, what a beautiful look at this racetrack. Time for the E3 Spark Plugs race analysis, Dave.
It'll be 300 laps today. Beautiful night for racing. 23 degrees and clear skies, and pit strategy could come into play.
A little bit of a curveball thrown to these teams. A lot of them came out expecting they would be able to get four change tires. Only two going to be allowed tonight.
Guys, a couple of stories to keep an eye on. The 27, our points leader, Andrew Ranger, has had his hands full with that car all day. NASCAR allowed the team to look underneath to make sure there wasn't a part malfunction. They're okay, but they hope for a lot of green flag laps, and then they'll have a better idea of where they are. Also, the 9 car of Adam Martin, they were having brake issues after qualifying, bled the brakes. They're hopefully good to go for 300 tonight.
Adam Martin making his third NASCAR start. As you see, he had a great run at Sunset Speedway, which is very similar to this Riverside track. So looking for big things of the youngster.
All right, man, 300 strong. Time to go to work. Coming to it this time.
Words of encouragement from the spotter. 300 laps this time, and Dave, this is a high-speed oval.
You see the drivers ready to go as they bunch up on the back straightaway. The pace car pulls down pit lane. It'll be Donald Chisholm in the 89, the 32 of Alex LeBay. Jason McDonald with Maritime Auto prepared with the green flag. There he gets the touch on the shoulder, and we're underway at Riverside.
Down the front straightaway, they charge into turn number one. A great start for Donald Chisholm in the 89, and he's cleared LeBay on the backstretch.
First time flying down the back straightaway. Look at the three of Jason Hathaway. A great qualifying effort for the Ray Vesta Chevy.
He actually looked relieved after qualifying. He's used to having to work so hard on these oval tracks because by his own admission, the qualifying program just isn't quite what it needs to be.
And he's had some horrible luck at times in 2016.
Looking for a strong run tonight. He's won at this racetrack before. 2 years ago, he was on his way to a win, but problems with the lap car cost him a great finish.
So LeBay drops back a couple of spots as a Castrol Edge Dodge of DJ Kennington gets around as well. This a little deeper in the field. The 0-2 of Mark Dilley and the 74 of Kevin Lacroix battling side-by-side for seventh spot.
Right behind them, we ride on board with 16-year-old Caden Lapcevich. Trying to decide which lane he wants. A little bit of contact there with Tagliani and LP Dumoulin.
And Lapcevich with a little bit of work to do here today as well, qualifying a little bit deeper in the field. Uncharacteristic on the ovals for the driver of the 76.
He's qualified on the front row of every oval race this year, with the exception of the one that he won in Saskatoon.
On board, 15-year-old Waylon Farrell. In his very first NASCAR Pinty Series start as he ducks underneath the former champion in the WeatherTech Dodge of LP Dumoulin.
And I'll tell you, LP Dumoulin's got a problem on that WeatherTech 47. He started in the second row and he is working his way steadily to the back.
He had a great effort the last time we were on the oval in Saskatoon. Coming home on the podium, did it as well in Edmonton the race before that. Thought he had his season turned around, but unfortunately here is struggling in the early going.
Now you might notice a different look for Gary Clute in the 59 machine. Pool Supplies Canada.ca is the sponsor, but it is very clearly a DJ Kennington car. They've made a deal with DJ Kennington. They've got some other projects in the works, so they've rented this ride for down east.
And Gary Clute announced that he will be driving a Kyle Busch Motorsports entry in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. That's big news.
The battle for fourth with Alex Tagliani on the inside of Alex LeBay. He'll clear him coming off turn number four.
How about the 18 of Alex Tagliani? We didn't talk about him when we looked at the points picture, but he sits solidly in third, just 27 points out of top spot. We're well underway here in Riverside. Donald Chisholm continues to lead. This NASCAR on TSN telecast from Nova Scotia is brought to you by E3 Spark Plugs, born to burn. And by Mopar, authentic performance. Still under green here at Riverside International Speedway. Donald Chisholm continues to lead, but this is a battle for eighth between the 59 of Gary Clute and Waylon Farrell in his first race out of Newfoundland.
Waylon Farrell is behind the wheel of a car that the Steckley team likes to call Bullet. He's won some races in that car, and he's secured championships in that car.
Scott Steckley has, of course, and Steckley, a winner here last year at Riverside Speedway, so he knows his way around. That's a very, very well-equipped car and well-prepared piece of equipment that Waylon Farrell is jumping into here today.
Absolutely right. A couple of drivers racing with yellow stripes on their back bumper. Of course, Waylon Farrell with his first ever start, and look how busy his hands are coming off the turns.
On board the youngster, he has the 74 of Kevin Lacroix just in behind him. There's another rookie, the 76 of Caden Lapcevich, second in points. chasing the veteran, the 0-2 of Mark Dilley.
Yeah, some rookie. He's been on the podium of every oval track race this season.
And this is a battle for sixth spot. Of course, those two drivers representing Sunset Speedway, a NASCAR home track in Ontario. Of course, representatives from that track, Mark Dilley, Caden Lapcevich, Adam Martin, and Dwayne Baker. They're all here.
Definitely well represented down here in Antigonish, Nova Scotia, as Kevin Lacroix continues to battle with Waylon Farrell, but Farrell's getting the hang of it every lap.
Look who's coming. The 18 of Alex Taglianni is reeled in, your third place driver, the 3 of Jason Hathaway.
Dave, I'm fascinated. We're on lap 31 of this event, and we've seen a number of cars with their brake rotors already glowing orange.
It's a tough track, though, because it's almost like a paperclip. You really have to get slowed down in the corners. Now, the high banking, you have 14 degrees banking in the corners. That'll help a little bit, but you have to lean on those brakes sometimes.
Wow, Waylon Farrell, all kinds of loose coming out of the corners. He almost leaned on the wall coming out of there as Kevin Lacroix goes around him on the inside, but Waylon Farrell fighting back on the high side.
Riding on board your points leader, Andrew Ranger, in the Mopar Penswell Dodge, and Farrell hits the wall down the back straightaway, catches the back bumper of the bumper-to-bumper number 74, Kevin Lacroix. Farrell off the pace now.
And Lacroix had passed him on the inside almost clear, and we're going to see here with the exception of his bumper cover. So he comes off the corner, tries to move up.
And that's not a gentle rub for Waylon Farrell. Have another look from outside in slow motion.
In hindsight, Farrell was probably better off to check up. Lacroix was a bit faster, but you're 15 years old in your first NASCAR race. Lacroix wasn't quite clear.
Needs to be said, though, we stay under green, and this now a battle for the race lead. You see Kennington has managed to reel in your race leader, Donald Chisholm. This is a battle for third and fourth between Hathaway and the 18 of Alex Taglianni.
And, of course, they run right behind the Johnsonville number 9 of Adam Martin. He has been lapped by the leader as Waylon Farrell pulls onto pit road.
Yeah, you can see the sidewalls of those Goodyear Eagles are completely white, and the crew not in any rush to get that car repaired. They'll check it out.
Side by side, the battle for third. Alex Taglianni on the inside of Jason Hathaway.
LeBay is on pit road to 32, pulls down pit lane, and he will... And there goes the 74 of Lacroix, also down pit lane. But you see the hood up on the Can-Am Ford Fusion.
Oh, what a terrible break for Alex LeBay as DJ Kennington has taken the lead in traffic.
Kennington sneaks around the 89 Ford Fusion of Donald Chisholm. Chisholm not giving up without a fight. You saw the 48 of Dwayne Baker up in the high group.
And one thing, Donald Chisholm, if there's an advantage to be had here, it is lap traffic. He runs more laps at this racetrack than anybody in this field. Of course, already won a huge 250-lap event here earlier this summer.
Pretty nice to have Riverside as your test track. And one driver who seems to be out of this one is the 32, Thompson is pitched. Huh?
Guys, it's the power steering on that 32 that's the problem for Alex LeBay. Doesn't have anything to do with the engine issues they were worried about earlier. It's power steering that's gone.
I don't think this is the kind of racetrack that you want to be messing around without power steering, Dave.
Oh, this would be a tough one. Those banks would grab those front tires and really pull on them. And this early in this race, there was no way he'd last 300 laps.
So DJ Kennington out in front. They go around the 83 of Ian Admiral. He goes up to the high side to get out of the way. And look who's about to go a lap down.
WeatherTech.ca Dodge of LB Dumoulin as the 17 Castrol-Edge Dodge of DJ Kennington tucked in behind. And it looks like Kennington will make a move here in the coming laps as we look back a little bit deeper in traffic. The 76 of Caden Lapcevich still glued to the back bumper, and you can see that bumper cover falling off the 0-2 of Mark Dilley. Now some smoke from the back end of that Johnsonville Ford.
I'd like to see how that developed. We got problems in behind, a car off the base, and there's a wheel off. Ian Admiral in the 83, the Swan Rentals car, will bring out the yellow.
And you can see the tire is cut down and the wheel completely off that car. Sparks from the 83 of Ian Admiral as the field slows for the first time here in the bumper-to-bumper 300. We'll have another look at what happened.
Down into turn number one, And he knew something was wrong. Something was screwy there. He shot up the racetrack and a little bit off the pace. Now we're going to see down into turn three.
And you can see the smoke off Gilly's car in there. Just up the track, the wheel finally gives up the ghost, and Admiral has found his way back to pit lane.
Well, I'll tell you, if you lose a wheel and don't hit something hard, you're lucky. Let's go down to Todd on pit road.
Just about everybody taking advantage of this caution period to add fuel. The 17 in, the leader of the 89 in, and a bunch of the front runners as well making their fuel stops this time by.
And the three of Jason Hathaway has left his pit with a fuel can still hanging on the back of the Ray Besta Chevy. There it is.
The good news, Dave, he got out of pit road first. The bad news, he's still got that fuel can hanging out of the number three. Finally shakes it loose.
You can see it spilling off into the infield. But we'll have to reset the field. Hathaway out first is your leader. Welcome back to Antigonish, Nova Scotia, race number 9 of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series. Hometown hero Donald Chisholm once again leads the bumper-to-bumper 300 as we get set for restart number 1 here on lap 68.
Jason Hathaway penalized to the tail end of the lead lap cars for this restart. That leaves Alex Tagliani at the front of the field. He'll lead him off of turn 2.
Tagliani down the backstretch with Donald Chisholm in tow. He'll try and lead this lap and pick up a bonus point, and he will do that. But Todd's pit side with one of the Admiral brothers.
He and Admiral, you and Kelly drove, I think it was 56 hours just to get here. What's put you out early from this one?
A brake fade early, and I thought the pads were getting soft, but the spindle came off the right front of the car on the back straight. Can't fix that here.
You know, we mentioned this track is so fast. In fact, I remember DJ Kennington hit the wall here in turn number 1, said that hit really, really hurt. The hardest hit you're going to get into the wall is when your right front suspension fails or that wheel comes off. Ian Admiral doesn't feel it right now, Dave, but he's pretty fortunate that wasn't a whole lot worse.
And laps just a shade over 15 seconds. You're not going to get the time like you would have on a road course. As you see the two drivers, these, the 46 and the 74, they tangled a little bit earlier on in this. Both caught the wall, and both are back side by side. Waylon Farrell in the 46, the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. They're back at it for 13th spot.
And Waylon Farrell driving hard. I can't quite tell if he's trying to get up all in the grill of Kevin Lacroix or just trying to drive around him and get away.
Looks like that time he was able to nose in front, but a car that looks strong is the 18 of Alex Tagliani, who leads this one as Chisholm gets crossways off the corner. And Kennington, will he capitalize? Yeah, the door stays open. Here comes the 17.
Chisholm left the lane open, and how do you like that? A Chevy, a Ford, and a Dodge in the top three, racing pretty darn close together. Kennington in the Castrol Edge Dodge clears the 89.
From the back bumper in the 17 of DJ Kennington to the nose of the 89. You see how high the nose gets up on the straightaway. It slams back down and gives the front end traction problems. On the 74, you see Kevin Lacroix. Looks like he may have a tire down. Sparks coming from the right front.
Big time sparks show out of the 74 machine. Let's have a look. He's up on the outside. Yeah, you can hear something go wrong. Heads up towards the wall, does a nice job of keeping that car off the concrete.
Just a rough day for the bumper-to-bumper crew as they'll get that right front replaced, but Kevin Lacroix going laps down while on pit lane. The 59 and the 47, a battle for sixth spot with LP Dumoulin and Gary Klute.
I don't know what that team changed on the 47 WeatherTech machine, but that car is much friendlier to drive for LP. He saved himself from going a lap down with that yellow flag. He looks like he's making the most of it now.
It just looks a lot happier looking at the back bumpers. Here comes Klute to the inside. He'll have to back out of that one as the door closes. Eighth spot for Mark Dilley in the Leland Johnsonville Ford. And he's waiting for something to happen just in front of him, just sort of playing that one out.
You know, there's so many racers here tonight, Dave, that are just screaming to have a good run. We just had a look at the three of Jason Hathaway. He's having a good run, even despite the fuel can problem. And here goes lots of it. Here's our points contenders racing for fourth.
Andrew Ranger in the 27 up on the outside. That's a place he has become very comfortable on these oval tracks. He usually finds that second groove fairly early.
And the reason he goes up there, it sort of conserves brakes, it conserves tires, and it's a line nobody else runs, Dave.
You saw the crew of Alex Taglianni looking on as the 18 in control here in Riverside. Your points contenders for the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series Championship are all over each other at Riverside Speedway, Nova Scotia. I'm Dave Bradley, along with Adam Ross and Todd Lewis is pit side, but look at this side-by-side action.
Fantastic three-way battle for the third spot. Donald Chisholm in third, he doesn't care about points. The two guys behind him sure do.
And you know what's funny about those two drivers? They're running side-by-side, but they're pushing each other so hard, they're able to reel in the 89 as they make contact down the back straightaway. Lapsovich and Ranger did.
That was awfully close as Ranger gives a wiggle from the outside. Lapsovich has to get to the inside of Chisholm before Ranger can get to the outside to secure that groove.
And it looks like Chisholm is sliding up into that outside lane, opening the door for the 76 of Lapsovich, so he'll be in the better position to assume a battle with the 89, and there he goes, side by side now.
Third spot to Caden Lapsovich. Andrew Ranger trying to get to the bottom. One difference with Andrew Ranger's Mopar 27, he's got a built engine in that race car. It's a little bit heavier package than the spec engine program a lot of these teams run. That's some of the reason why he runs up high, can keep that momentum up, so when he has to drop to the bottom to make a pass, you can see the car is not quite as comfortable.
See the Johnsonville number 9 of Adam Martin just in ahead of the 76 of Caden Lapsovich, and Adam Martin a lap down in the early going of this one. Is there is the front of the field, the 18 of Alex Taglianni, the yellow and black Chevy, leads this one. The 17 is DJ Kennington holding down second, but still has Taglianni in his sights.
It's almost a half a straightaway between Alex Taglianni in the lead, DJ Kennington back in second, and this typically is a race where you will have a long green flag stretch, similar to what we see at Sunset Speedway or what we used to see at Cayuga Speedway.
Sparks flying as the cars hammer that bump down the back straightaway into turn number 3 as we ride on board Jason Hathaway.
Hathaway runs in the 7th position, but they're 6th and 5th right in front of him.
And Andrew Ranger now back to the 47 of LB Dumoulin. So this is about to become a very, very complicated battle with a lot of drivers involved. Is Ranger still running that upper groove? The 47 is coming back hard in the WeatherTech.ca Dodge.
We also mentioned traditionally this is a race where you can put 4 fresh Goodyear tires on the car during the race. It's been changed to a 2-tire race, Dave. The left side tires that they started this race on are the tires they're going to run all 300 laps with.
Dumoulin tucks to the inside. They're both crossways. And Ranger gets a bump off of turn number 2 as Dumoulin sticks it on the inside, but both are struggling to get some traction and keep those cars straight.
No kidding. And they're still door handle side by side, but that could have been tragic for these two drivers.
And that's not going to make Andrew Ranger happy in the 27 as you see sparks coming out of the number 27 as he bangs the ground. So something happening in the 47 makes contact again.
Hathaway goes to the inside, 3 wide for the moment, and Hathaway backs out of it. Oh my goodness, Kelly Admiral with a problem on the Omvic 56.
Down pit lane as we resume this battle between the 47 and the 27. And now it looks like Andrew Ranger falling back just a little bit as Dumoulin able to make that pass stick. And sparks off the pace as the Mopar Dodge, your points leader.
Big problems for Ranger. He is off the pace and a full lap from the entrance to pit road.
Tip hop. All the way. Hold it up there. Inside. Got a big line that's coming here. Big line.
What we're hearing is his spotter, Steve Simmons, telling him there's a big line of cars, you gotta stay to the outside.
And it's a left front tire. You saw the sparks coming off of it, and Ranger pulls to a stop, and that will draw the caution flag here in the bumper-to-bumper 300.
That might also draw the attention of race director Trevor Hambley, but the spotter's saying there's no opportunity to get down, and with a flat front tire, it's very difficult to control the car, so all sorts of things going wrong there at the same time.
So they got fuel during the first caution period. They're looking for tires this time. Todd's down pit lane as the leaders come in. Todd?
And
everyone taking advantage of this caution period to make scheduled pit stops. Going to be right side tires for that 18. 76 overshoots his pit box just a little bit. They push him back, and now the crew goes to work on those right side tires as well. Smooth service so far up front. Looks like Alex Tagliani will lead everybody out again.
I think it's a slow stop for Caden Laxmich. You saw the Jackman having trouble getting the jack under, Dave.
And he is still sitting on pit lane as all the rest of the lead pack heads out onto the racetrack. Tagliani, the first one out, he continues to lead. Preparing for the second restart of the evening here on lap 149, Alex Tagliani is your race leader. And there you see the green flag waves as Tagliani gets a jump into turn one.
Once again, launches out in front, gets a great restart, able to use all of the racetrack. And with two brand new tires on the outside, Dave, they haven't come up to temperature. It's a great feeling when you can use all the racetrack, not have to worry about holding a line.
And we should mention, too, that the 48 of Dwayne Baker receiving the free pass during that caution period as the 59 of Gary Clute rubs fenders with the 89 of Donald Chisholm.
And just before that, it was LP Dumoulin in the 47 rubbing wheels halfway through the bumper-to-bumper 300.
So far, the race has pretty much been all Alex Tagliani's. Early race leader was the 89 of Donald Chisholm as we ride on board the Celtic Four.
And NASCAR officials have come over the radio. It's going to be a penalty for Andrew Ranger. One lap for bringing out the caution.
Remember, he was your points leader coming into this one. He had 5 points between him and the 76 of Caden Lapcevich. So if you're Caden Lapcevich, more importantly, if you're Jeff Lapcevich on top of the pit boxes, there you see the 27 coming down pit lane to serve his penalty. But if you're Jeff Lapcevich, what do you tell your driver?
You know, you've got to be points racing, and they'll be cognizant of that. They also just had a bad pit stop. So you've got a 16-year-old driver who's further back in the field than he deserves to be. So, yeah, there's got to be some solid communication to try to make sure he stays calm.
You see the front, the splitter of the 76 of Caden Lapcevich, fluorescent yellow, so he's easy to pick out in the crowd. There he is battling with the 59 of Gary Clute.
And you want to talk about a family affair. Jeff Lapcevich has been on the box all year long, calling the shots over the radio. This weekend, Caden's mom, Sherry, is also on the radio. This is a racing family. Everybody who's a Lapcevich understands this sport.
Look at the Castrol Edge Dodge, though, of DJ Kennington. He's always been quick every time we come to Riverside Speedway, and he's quick once again here today and catching your race leader.
Donald Chisholm gives a little nudge to LP Dumoulin in the 47. It's a three-way battle led by Jason Hathaway in the three as he slides up the banking.
On board, Donald Chisholm's number 89. He's pretty smooth here, isn't he?
And that's where he gains all his ground, as you see him go to the inside of Dumoulin. And even with all this banking, you still can't tromp on the gas pedal. You have to ease into the throttle. And if the car's working, rotating the center the way you want it to, you can get that advantage, and that's what Donald Chisholm did to LP Dumoulin.
You saw the right front rotor glowing on the 89, though, as we ride on board now with a Castrol Edge Dodge. DJ Kennington, he is in chase mode. He has Alex Tagliani in his sights. Welcome back to race number 9 of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series, the bumper-to-bumper 300 at Riverside International Speedway. These two drivers have been the class of the field so far today. Alex Tagliani.
And we hear the spotters hard at work. With the speeds they run at this racetrack, you don't want to move up or down the track until you get the clear sign. Fletcher talking to Gary Clute. He's been around this game for an awfully long time as well. Of course, his brother John Fletcher, the crew chief on the 59.
The Pool Supplies Canada.ca number 59 having a very, very good run. Gary Clute, another one of those drivers, came into 2016 with super high hopes and unfortunately has been bitten by the bad luck bug this year.
Man, there's a few drivers that have really struggled, and it's not performance related, it's not preparation related, it's just lady luck is not shown on these drivers.
There's Andrew Ranger, not too far ahead of the 18 of Alex Tagliani. You'll remember Ranger had to go to the pits to serve a penalty for bringing out a caution for a left front flat tire. So he is not currently on the lead lap as he's currently battling with the 46 of Waylon Farrell on track. Those two drivers going side by side. Here's a side by side battle, Lapcevic and Chisholm.
Caden Lapcevic, after that poor pit stop, having to work through the field. And you can see in front of these two cars, he's got a lot of open racetrack.
And a look forward from the 89 of Chisholm and the 74 of Kevin Lacroix, several laps down after making a pit stop just a little while ago. And now the 47 of LP Dumoulin working lap traffic. He's up to fourth spot, having a great run. This is exactly what this team needs.
Wow, and he did not clear the 46 by much as he slid up to the wall. And you can hear the spotter saying five cars behind you. What that means is five car lengths behind you to the next car.
It's pretty much telling him to relax a little bit, take care of your tires, take care of your brakes, because what you have now, you've made your pit stops, these are the cards you're going to play with for the rest of the hit.
And there's still a lot of race left to go. So an instinct for any driver, if you can drive away from the field, is to do it. Just drive away. But you really have to conserve a little bit if it's within you to do it.
Good look at the Chevrolet of Jason Hathaway. Recently married Jason Hathaway. So a big congratulations to him and his lovely wife, Jamie Hackinson.
And Hudson, of course, their son, a big part of the wedding as well.
Don't give him so much room coming off the corner.
And give the spot to Klute in the Pool Supplies Canada.ca number 59.
They ran about an entire lap right side by side, but this is why they have to go. Look at Alex Tagliani right behind them.
And off the pace, the 89 of Chisholm. We got problems.
Oh!
Dilly goes around and he caught your race leader.
And Tagliani got a big piece of that, Dave. He's got heavy, heavy damage.
So it was Gary Klute and Mark Dilley who made initial contact, but look at the damage to the EpiPen Chevrolet of Alex Tagliani.
He was out in front controlling this race. And where's Dilley going? Let's have a look. Gary Klute in the 59 in the middle of the screen, and boy, oh boy.
So there's the contact, and there is where Tagliani is collected.
And Mark Dilley is not happy right now. He's going the wrong way around the racetrack because we're on board with him, having a look at him spinning around. And there's where Tagliani got into the back end.
It's not a light hit. You can see the right front tire is down, body pieces hanging off the EpiPen Chevy. And there's Dilley. He's looking for revenge or something, but
well,
he's gonna
he
have
found
a chat.
It. He found it. He looked at DJ Kenyon in the 50 or in the 17. It's identical to the 59, but now he's up alongside Gary Klute, giving him a piece of his mind, and Klute takes off and drives away.
And Tagliani's in the pit stop.
And just like that, fortunes change for the 18 team. You see body damage on the right front, the crew going to work to change that right front tire. They want to clear that away and make sure that there is no suspension damage and make sure that those brake lines are intact.
Tyler Case on top of the pit box calling out instructions. That team is very good at what they do, so they'll survey the damage and see what can be done.
A lot of cars on pit lane getting damage fixed. Getting some tape put on those body panels to keep them held on for the stretch drive as Tagliani rejoins the racetrack. Kennington, though, is your new leader. As the Dodge Challenger SRT Hellcat pace car pulls off the racetrack, the 17 of DJ Kennington rubs fenders with the 3 of Jason Hathaway as we get back to green in the bumper-to-bumper 300.
Tagliani takes the restart at the tail of the field, Dave, but he is not up to speed at all.
But look at this battle at the front. They're rubbing each other as they head into turn number 3. Don't count out the 47 of LP Dumoulin right in there as well.
These are 3 cars. Well, the 2 at the front, DJ Kennington and Jason Hathaway, they need him. Oh, my goodness. Hathaway almost wrecked it coming off the corner contact with Kennington.
And that wasn't a light hit either. DJ Kennington will tuck back in the second as Jason Hathaway assumes the lead in the Choco number 3.
I'm not sure where Hathaway would have wound up if Kennington wasn't there to hit him, because he was so loose, he had to chase the car down the track.
and he's still loose. He's driving it off the right rear, off the corners, just like a dirt track. In the Ray Best is number three, and that might have been a little payback.
That might have been definitely some contact between the top two. These two drivers are no strangers, the only two drivers in the history of the series to compete in every event.
Well, very much a veteran behind the wheel of both of those race cars, and LP Dumoulin right in there as well. You know, he's sitting behind the wheel of his car and thinking, I'm just gonna hang out here for a little while, but he can't hang out too long. Here comes Lapcevic.
Yeah, look at fourth and fifth. Lapcevic in the 76, Donald Chisholm in the 89, and look at that. Hathaway keeps it off the wall.
They hit so hard, there was sparks from those two cars.
And he would have gathered the car in eventually. I'm just wondering how far it would have slid before he reeled it in. But now they're pulling away from Dumoulin.
And we should say, too, that the 27 of Andrew Ranger has now pulled off the racetrack and is in pit lane. As we look at the 76 of Caden Lapcevic, so your points leader coming into this event is out of tonight's event.
And I think this answers your question of whether Lapcevic is going to take it easy and earn points. He was right up in the business of LP Dumoulin coming out of four last lap.
Lapcevic is a young lion. Caution flag flies.
Reports of debris on the racetrack. Debris will bring out the yellow.
And so that'll slow down the field and let us catch our breath. There it is, just a piece of sheet metal on the racetrack, but that's big enough to cut down a tire. So the NASCAR officials erring on the side of caution, throwing it here in the late going. Welcome back to the Bumper to Bumper 300 and race number 9 of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series. I'm Dave Bradley. Along in the booth is Adam Ross, and Don Lewis is trackside, but we have our attention on the front row as we go back to green. Hathaway and Kennington into turn one.
45 laps to go. This is a Saturday night special now, Dave.
And look now, they're rubbing for second spot as LP Dumoulin lanes on the 17 of DJ Kennington. Kennington must be thinking, what do I have a target on?
Kennington goes hard rudder left, trying to keep LP Dumoulin down the racetrack, but Dumoulin is determined.
And he gets up close to him once again. They're just about a business card between them. Here comes Lapcevic looking to take advantage of that battle.
Yeah, I almost think Caden recognized that DJ Kennington is ticked right off. Don't get involved. He backed out of it. Still running in the fourth position, but we've not seen the end of this battle.
Absolutely not. The 17 came down hard in front of the 76. You see the 0-2 off Mark Dilley, currently five laps down in the Leland Johnsonville Ford.
That was one of our teams that needed a positive break tonight. Two of the other teams, the three of Hathaway, the 17 of Kennington, still up in the top three.
Now, Dilley is battling alongside the Celtic number 89 of Donald Chisholm. Chisholm is inside the top five, currently sitting in fifth.
And he's got to be a little bit annoyed that Dilley is driving him as hard as he is.
And now the leader goes around the lap down car of Alex Tagliani, who makes life just a little bit difficult for the number three of Jason Hathaway, but he manages to clear him.
I'm not really sure why that just happened, but it certainly brought the leaders a little closer together.
That might just be something is bent in the front end of the EpiPen number 18, as Tagliani couldn't quite make that corner down on the yellow line.
As I think about it a little bit more, Dave, those two had some run-ins at Saskatoon a few races ago.
Could it be bad luck? You never know. But either way, we've got a battle for third spot, and Caden Lapcevic has a nose ahead of the 17 of DJ Kennington. Although Lapcevic did not hit Kennington, that's one of the few cars that hasn't hit the 17.
That's the first car to make a pass on DJ without driving into the door. We talk like it's easy, Dave, and it's certainly not. There's so much going on inside these race cars, but you can see a few war wounds on some of these cars, and Lapcevic barely a mark on it.
Especially in the late going of one of these races when the tires start to get worn out. But the three of Jason Hathaway, can today be the day he turns around his 2016 fortunes? He currently has a significant lead of four car lengths over the 47 WeatherTech Dodge of LP Dumoulin.
And we could see in that shot right there, there's a handful of drivers, five drivers on the lead lap that are going to settle this score. But they're all on the same straightaway. They're all still in contention.
Young Caden Lapcevic now right behind the 47, battling for second. DJ Kennington not out of it, and there again the 18 and the 3 are side by side. The 18 of Tagliani is laps down. The 3 of Jason Hathaway is your race.
full second a lap when the three cars beside him.
Well, then he tucks down out of the way, and look at the gap now between your race leader and second place, LP Dumoulin. Hathaway, now it's only about two car lengths back to Dumoulin.
And the fans will appreciate it. These Maritimes fans are being treated to a fantastic stock car race.
Look at this. We're down to the final throws of this bumper-to-bumper 300. The top four cars all covered by a blanket on the front straightaway.
And Caden Lapsevich finds his opportunity. Dumoulin goes up the racetrack. Lapsevich drives to the inside. Right now, keeping that 76 right along the yellow line and makes the pass on LP Dumoulin. Remember, Dumoulin and Kennington had some run-ins earlier.
And Dumoulin will pull it right down to the inside as we ride on board the 76 of Caden Lapsevich. And he's pulled up right to the back bumper of the three of Jason Hathaway.
We saw Jason Hathaway super loose after that restart. The car looks to be handling quite a bit better, but with Caden Lapsevich closing in on his back bumper, moving to the inside, Hathaway's going to have to try to pick up the pace.
Brake rotor glowing on the 76 Dodge of Caden Lapsevich is starting to glow on the 3 of Jason Hathaway as he needs to pick up the pace to keep Lapsevich behind him. Again, Lapsevich came into this one second in points.
The launch that Caden has gotten off of turn number two.
Drive deep here, drive deep. Just hit your bumper. Coming back to you. Wheel, wheel with room. Wheel, coming back tight, door.
That's spotter Jeff Gutler for the 3 of Jason Hathaway.
Coming back even.
Coaching his driver through this pass is Lapsevich on the inside. He has a nose. Can he make it stick down low? Hathaway's going to come back solid up high.
Lapsevich still hasn't quite cleared the three. What a wise move to keep the car down the bottom. Now he'll clear him down into turn number one and take the lead for the first time down the backstretch.
You'll remember the last time the series visited an oval. It was in Saskatoon, and the winner was the 76 of Caden Lapsevich.
Within 10 laps to go, Caden Lapsevich takes the lead. What a huge opportunity this could be for the Lapsevich team.
Now he just has to settle down and keep the field behind him. He's going to work some lap traffic here very shortly as the 18 of Taglianni's on the same straightaway to the inside for second spot. Looks like the three cars struggling in the last few laps.
Wow, how many cars are going to make contact as the Taglianni 18 comes into play as well? Dumoulin with the spot. DJ Kennington slides on through as well.
Hathaway lucky to gather that one back up. And now he makes contact with the 17 of DJ Kennington. Kennington off the pace just a little bit.
Yeah, Kennington checks up into the corner. 5 laps to go, and Kennington is off the pace.
So Kennington weaving side to side. It looks like he's out of gas.
You weave the car side to side, trying to get the fuel to the pickup line in the fuel cell.
And he's on the flat of the racetrack, too, so that helps trying to get the fuel to the pickup area.
Now, this could bring out a yellow. DJ Kennington awfully slow as Jeff Lapsevich looks on.
So the 27 of Andrew Ranger currently in 14th position. There is your race leader, the 76 of Caden Lapsevich. So this looks like it could be a very big points day for the rookie Lapsevich.
Okay, DJ Kennington has still not made it to pit road. And if the yellow comes out, that could change everything.
Kennington still marked in the fifth position, just ahead of the 48 of Dwayne Baker. As you see the ticker across the top of your screen, just 2 laps to go, still no caution.
It looks like he's out of harm's way now. He's down onto pit lane. So if the white flag comes out, and here it is, the next flag ends this race. Lapsevich just needs to hit his marks.
And he has a lot of space in between him and second place, the 47 of LP Dumoulin, but Caden Lapsevich looking to take over the points lead. He'll win his second of the season in Riverside.
LP Dumoulin comes home second, Jason Hathaway third, and the Fastline Motorsports team celebrates on pit road.
The 76 machine has pulled into victory lane here at Riverside International Speedway, and Todd standing by. Todd?
Cold drink of water, checkered flag in his hand. 16-year-old Caden Lapsevich climbing up on the roof of that number 76 to a shower of confetti and that big smile on his face. A little slippery on that roof when you climb up there, but with all the practice you're getting, it should become easier. What a car you had at the end of this race.
Well, I actually broke the door this time doing it, so but it was all about saving, and you know, I fell back there at the start, and you know, just rode. That's all I could really do to save it at the end. Dad's like, you're using too much. I'm like, all right, I'll back myself down a little bit more. So, you know, I saved the left rear. It was hard, easy on my right rear tire there at the end. And, you know, this is awesome. Two in a row. I couldn't imagine it. And, I couldn't have done it without all my sponsors. Ace Services, Springer's Meats, Cathcart Trucking, Troy Cove Marine, who just had a tragic fire at the marina. So, you know, this one's for them out there, and we're all thinking of them.
Caden Lapcevich, victory number 2 on the season. And guys, he now takes over the championship points lead.
A popcorn shower from brother Ryden as more siblings of the Lapcevich clan join in. And now you see the points, 12 between Lapcevich and Ranger.
Tagliani, 32 points back. That's almost an insurmountable lead. But how about LP Dumoulin? Picked up 2 spots in the points tonight. Todd's with him.
LP Dumoulin with another podium finish. This is starting to become a habit for you, but it was tough at the start. You slid way back into the field, but patience proved to be the recipe at the end.
Yeah, we had the car set up for long runs. The car was a little loose at the beginning of the race, but we knew the track would tie it up. So that WeatherTech Benmar car was fast in the long run. The team did a really good job in the pit. My crew chief Billy Burns and all the staff did awesome job, so we can finish again second. But till the end of the season, the only thing we look for is winning, and that's all. Let's go. We're good. We're happy.
Big smile on his face as we take a look at the top 10 of your finishing order here in the bumper-to-bumper 300. There you see Dumoulin in second spot. But how about Dwayne Baker, top 5 today in the 48?
Great run for Baker. Adam Martin finishes up in the 6th position. A couple of drivers that persevered and made it to the checkered flag, Dave.
And on the front straightaway, Adam, a happy Lapcevich family posing for the victory lane pictures.
The family's all there. Jeff and Sherry, Caden, Trayton, Ryden, and Jan, and Uncle Jimmy drove the hauler.
The Bumper to Bumper 300 has been brought to you by Leland Industries, a proud Canadian fastener company, and by Honeygoo from CleanFlow on Honeyvaloo. So Caden Lapcevich lifts the trophy high here at Riverside Speedway. The next race back on a road course at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, the Can-Am 200.
One of the biggest weekends of the year for NASCAR in Canada.
From all of us at TSN, we'll see you there.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our loyal fans for your continued support, and we hope you enjoyed today's broadcast.